they were able to.
President Muhammadu Buhari last week commissioned the $1.5 billion 156 kilometers Lagos-Ibadan standard gauge rail line project for full commercial activities in Lagos. From the beginning of this administration, railway infrastructure development have been given the priority it deserves and various milestones have been reached. The Lagos-Ibadan line is a double-track standard gauge rail, and it is expected to provide linkages, job opportunities, and also boost trade in the Southwest Corridor with ripple effects on the economy. Aside the boost to the economy, it will be stating the obvious that the railway is not just an alternative and comfortable mode of transport, it also holds the master key to transforming commerce in Nigeria and across the continent. What other added value services will the Lagos-Ibadan rail line provide? What impact will the introduction of additional round trips have on economic activities on the axis? These and more are the focus on Panorama, coming to you live from the Lagos Network Center. I am Adeola Komi Akiri. President Muhammadu Buhari has flagged off work for the NLNG Train 7 plant project in Bonny Island, River State, with assurance that the Nigerian gas resources will continue to grow in the future. The NLNG Train 7 project will increase the production capacity of the NLNG by 35%, raising generation of the current 22 million tons per annum to 30 million tons.
To the world by harnessing our natural resources. This groundbreaking ceremony to herald the Train 7 project construction affords me the opportunity to congratulate Nigerian LNG and its shareholders, NNPC, Shell, Total, and ENI, for proving that a Nigerian company can operate a world-class business, A, safety, B, profitability, and see responsibly.
This expansion will also ensure that Nigeria, with its significant gas reserves and being ninth largest in the world, remains on top, reliable and preferred supplier of LNG in the expanding energy world. Vice President Yemi Osinbajo this Sunday in Lagos inaugurated a social enterprise foundation which aim is to raise funds and resources for indigenous grassroots charities working with orphaned and vulnerable children, disadvantaged youth and victims of domestic violence. State House correspondent Gideon Ifade reports.
It is a commitment to the notion that all service to man is actually service to God. And as Vice President Yemi Osinbajo acknowledges while inaugurating the Dash Min Foundation, the elite own the people, especially the poor and disprivileged, not just empathy, but concrete and creative provision to enable them live their best lives. The Vice President commends the initiator and visioner of the foundation, former Minister of Finance Kemi Adeosun, saying, "It is clear that the ultimate objective of the foundation is not to be an alms giver, but a powerful institution for the creation of wealth and opportunity to the less privileged."
It's a unique model which does not just give to the needy in the conventional way of merely handing out donations. It's an innovative and structured way of bringing donations together, of aggregating donations to earn income to transform the lives of the vulnerable and needy while creating jobs in the process.
And we're seeing increasing numbers of children abandoned. There are a number of stories, a few of the orphanage owners are here, of stories of children that are literally left outside the local government office with a loaf of bread. And the orphanage has to then try and work out what's the age of the child. They don't know the name of the child. They don't know the background of the child.
Vice President Yemi Osinbajo paid a courtesy visit to the Onigbo of Ifiru-Land, Oba Abdulwasiu Omogbola home, Abisogun II, who is marking his first anniversary as the 16th Onigbo of Ifiru-Land. In Lagos, Jide Onifade, NTA News.
First Lady of Nigeria, Aisha Muhammadu Buhari, has emphasized the need for the wives of the service chiefs and wife of the Inspector General of Police to give their maximum support to their husbands in order to ensure maximum security of the country. The First Lady stated this when she received the spouses of the service chiefs who paid her a familiarization visit at the State House. Aliyu Kabir reports.
The wives of the service chiefs and that of the Inspector General of Police were at the State House to restate their support and commitment to the First Lady of Nigeria, Aisha Muhammadu Buhari, in her quest to provide services to the less privileged Nigerians, especially women, youth and children. The First Lady, who expressed confidence in their capabilities as wives of the top security managers in the country, underscored the role of the spouses of public servants in nation building and charged them to optimize their contributions in that regard, while commending them for their steadfastness in serving the military families since their assumption as leaders of various associations of military wives. The First Lady urged them to remain resolute at ensuring regular and timely payment of benefit of retired and deceased soldiers, so that the affected families who are their members do not suffer unduly. The First Lady is optimistic that the authority is doing everything possible at ensuring more security officers are brought in towards addressing the security challenges facing the country.
Some of them, our families, are yet to get the benefits they're supposed to get. And then, like the police, we are losing them every now and then, and there's no much replacement. In which we'll have to use this opportunity to get the Chief of Defence Staff to hasten the payment of the benefit of the deceased military people and also families, and also for the police maybe to use the opportunity to speak to the wife of the Inspector General Police to help us encourage her husband to stand firm and make sure that enough recruitment will be made in due course, so that it will complement the number of the policemen that died.
We came to see the First Lady because she is our mother. She's the mother of the nation. And you know what our husbands are doing for the nation. We came to let her know that she has all our support as the mother of the nation.
They reaffirmed to work in synergy towards ensuring a better country for all. From the State House, Aliyu Kabir, NTA News.
With the inauguration of the Lagos-Ibadan standard gauge rail line by President Muhammadu Buhari comes the introduction of additional round trips along the axis, eliciting a lot of excitement from the residents. In this report, Michael Olaleye examines the prospects and challenges that comes with the development.
A presidential approval signaling the commencement of commercial service on the Lagos-Ibadan rail line. It symbolizes go, explore, and prosper. But the hurdles ahead are huge and basically anchored around how to reposition the rail subsector to deliver greater values.
Up till 1985, the railway handled between 80 and 85% of freight leaving the Apapa port as well as the Port Harcourt port.
Professor Bamidele Badejo, providing an insight on the target that must be achieved by the rail means of transportation in order to reclaim its old glory. It is a goal respondents believe is achievable once government leverages on population size and volume of trade along the corridor.
People can now move their farm produce easily from their farms to the markets. So it's a great boost to farmers. Increase in agricultural production will also be there.
Experts say creating an industrial hub around the rail corridor and provision of ancillary services along the Lagos-Ibadan rail line will stimulate growth faster than imagined.
This will not be sufficient for the kind of crowd we have between Lagos and Ibadan. Also, they still need to do a bit of work in the ticketing so that people can access it online.
When you are traveling, you also want to have a station experience. You want to park your cars well or have a proper taxi stand. You want the stations to be fully equipped so that, you know, you can get to the station while waiting for your train.
The connecting bus stops to each of the sub-terminals must be integrated so that it doesn't constitute another bunch of bottleneck and problem in the very near future. Rail transport is capital intensive, is labor extensive, is technological driven. So we must be up and doing in order to make sure that our investment on the rail transport is not in nullity.
Apart from passenger service, there is also a major concern on fast-tracking cargo checks and clearance at the seaport so that freight service on the standard gauge rail line will be maximally utilized. In Lagos, Michael Olaleye, NT News.
And joining us live to discuss more on gains accruable from the Lagos-Ibadan Rail Line project is Fide Tokiria, Managing Director, Nigerian Railway Corporation. Congratulations once more, sir, and thank you for joining us on Panorama today.
Good afternoon, Nigerians. Congratulations to all Nigerians, and it's a pleasure being here today.
Thank you. Now, at the start of the year, you projected round trips, but just two have been added. And after the inauguration by President Buhari, is your projection still feasible?
Yeah, you see, while you are dreaming of good things, you have to make sure that it's properly planned and you don't start and stop.
Yes.
So while the track laying was substantially completed, we couldn't leave the track near Yenado.
Okay.
So we started an operation, taking one trip in the morning from Ibadan and going back by 4 p.m. from Lagos.
Okay.
Then immediately after the commissioning and flag off and some of the stations were ready, we introduced another rake of trains, which makes it two from Lagos to Ibadan and two from Ibadan to Lagos.
Daily.
Okay. And our goal is to increase it to four up, four down by first week of July.
Okay.
And by the end of the year, we have eight up, eight down.
Okay.
So we have to, crawl.
Before you start learning to walk and
even. Yeah. And we are happy that the reception of the service we are providing is looking up. But it's going to cost us some money to continue to run before we get to the breakable point.
Okay.
And knowing that Nigerians are the end beneficiary of what we are doing, the staff, management, are trying to put in extra work to ensure people benefit from what the government have done for them. We started yesterday in the afternoon.
Okay.
From Lagos, that being the first time we are doing a train from
Lagos to Ibadan.
To Ibadan that time. And this morning we ran another train from Ibadan. That is the first time.
Okay.
And we got 87 passengers.
Oh, that's good. Impressive.
Yeah. And we ran one from Ibadan yesterday. we had 137 passengers. That is also the first time we ran from Ibadan in the evening to Lagos. So this morning, we have about 387 passengers from Lagos. And the build-up is coming, and the station has not been fully deployed because you have to arrange proper cleaning to ensure that people, now it's a thing of beauty to look, but if you make the mistake, the noise will be louder than the noise we have now. You know, bad news is good. It's good news.
All right, so, now, with this increase in the round trips, are you thinking of reduction in the fares? Because right now, it's to some people, it's still pretty high.
You see, we are going to introduce different types of service.
Okay.
You have different coaches. So we are going to have the train ride from 7,005 to 2,005. That is the type of service we are going to provide. Okay. We have a type of coach that can take 24 people. You can collapse the chair like you have in a train.
Okay, so it's like your first class, second class, and third class.
So, and that train service will take off from Lagos and not stop straight to Ibadan. So, and that will cost 7,005. Okay. We have a train that will stop in all these A station between Butemeta, that is the Mobolaje Junction station, and the Chief Obafemi Olugbenga station at Monia. It will stop in every station, and that will come at 2,500.
Okay. Right.
So, because you heard the professor saying that the train operation is not cheap, it's better we'll be able to provide service and sustain it. We don't just lick the sugar and throw So, we'll continue to make it sweet for people to want it.
Okay, feed it, just a minute. We shall take a break. This is still Panorama, but when we come back, we'll continue with this great development. Thank you for still staying with us. We're still with the Managing Director, Nigeria Railway Corporation, Fideth Ohiria. And back to you, sir. Now, now the rail is ready. How far with requests for collaboration and partnership? And Lagos is also planning to, you know, integrate the blue rail. Now, tell us, are there any other requests from states, you know, with all that is happening right now?
We have been collaborating with Lagos State Government through LAMATA, and they were having in mind of doing a separate track, two lines for the Lagos Red Line. But we advise them that what matters in train operation is not the number of lines we have, it's good communication, good signaling, and
efficiency.
So they have, we have come into an understanding that they will take it from the Butemeta Junction, where we branch off to Apapa, to Edo, and maybe eventually link up with the blue line. That is the one coming from Okokomaiko to Marina. So we are working on that seriously, and they tend to also have a station at Oyinbo to link up with their bus train service. Same time, you also want to have a station at Ikeja. We are collaborating and working as a team.
Yes.
And we are providing the relevant advice to them, and we are supporting them. People are coming up with various ideas, and we are open to receive them and discuss both the merit and the merit of the idea they are bringing. At the end, we get to a point that we work with them, like people come and say, okay, we want to introduce wagons to you, we want to bring in locomotive.
Yes.
And I say, okay, it's open. Let's discuss it and let's see how you are going to bring it in and how you are going to utilize it. And we are providing the necessary advice. And we wish that will happen soon, so that, because I know by time we stabilize. The freight is there, the load is there, the passengers are there.
Yes.
And as I tell people, it will be government cannot do it all, so we should encourage people to come in. those who think that the situation is not ripe, I believe the situation is ripe.
Okay.
It's just when you have an agreement, that agreement stands out in whether the Act has provided that you can partner with anybody, company or state.
All right, so negotiations are still ongoing.
On, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about quickly before we round up because time is not on our side right now. When will electronic ticketing be introduced along the corridor? Briefly, sir.
In Abuja, we have introduced it, but you still have to go through due diligence, due process to show that you are getting the right person who can do it. What when we did the Abuja Kaduna, it was restricted to Abuja Kaduna. Mm-hmm. Now we are going to do an advert as required by law, and we follow the due process, and the ICROC will come in, the BPP will come in, at the end we get a rightful person who will deploy the electronic ticketing, not only Lagos, but Itakbewori, and probably the narrow gauge.
Okay, thank you very much, Fideth Okiria, Managing Director, Nigeria Railway Corporation. I will wish that it will continue the rail lines and people will actually enjoy and learn to protect national assets. Thank you for joining us on Panorama today.
Thank you. It's a pleasure talking to you.
Still on Panorama today, the latest figures from the Nigeria Center for Disease Control as at the 14th of June 2021 shows that 12 new cases of the coronavirus have been recorded in two states of the Federation, bringing the total number of confirmed cases to 167,078 in Nigeria. Out of the new infections, Lagos recorded 9 new cases, while Kwara had 3 new cases, a total of 163,469 persons have been discharged, and sadly, 2,117 deaths have been recorded across the country. And Clement Olorotoba will now give us sports update.
Newly crowned champions of the maiden North Central Invitational Tournament, Team Kwara are still basking in the euphoria of their victory over Team FCT after winning by 11 runs. Team Kwara posted 62 runs and lost 4 wickets in the first innings, while Team FCT lost 5 wickets, posting 51 runs in the second innings.
I feel very excited about the match. We won. We played 3 games and we won it all. Although we're prepared for this tournament because and we came here and we have to do what we have to do, and we came and we conquered, and that's a great thing for me.
And now to football. Representatives of FCT to the National ITO Cup, Nigerian Air Force FC and Beautiful Tall Angels have promised to make Abuja proud when the competition gets underway later in the year. Both teams were crowned champions on Sunday, having defeated their rivals to pick their sole tickets to represent FCT.
You have a very good chance to do well in the National Challenge Cup because football is not played outside, it's played in the pitch. By God's grace, we are going to do well. We have a good team. Any team we meet, by God's grace, we are going to defeat.
Denmark team doctor says Christian Eriksen was gone, but tests conducted so far looks normal. He said he was gone. We did cardiac resuscitation. It was a cardiac arrest. How close we were to losing him, I don't know, but we got him back after one defeat, so that's quite fast. Christian Eriksen collapsed on Saturday in an Euro 2020 match between Finland and Denmark. Clement Olorontoba, NT News.
On that sporting note, we'll wrap up Panorama. Today came to you from the Lagos Network Center. I am Adeola Komiakere. Enjoy the rest of the day.